In this video, we will learn about what is Indian Ocean Dipole, which is often called the IOD. What are the reasons behind its occurrence? Then we will also learn about the three phases of Indian Ocean Dipole, which is neutral, negative and positive phase. And in the end, we will learn how it affects the monsoons in India. So let's get right into it. From the name, you can easily figure out that this phenomenon occurs in the Indian Ocean. And the word dipole is used in physics, which means two ends that have opposite sides. For example, a magnet. A magnet has two opposite sides, the North Pole and the South Pole. So these two sides are called as dipole. Now when you look at the term Indian Ocean Dipole, it means there have to be two sides in the Indian Ocean with respect to sea surface temperatures. Indian Ocean lies in the tropical region. This is the western side and this is the eastern side. There is an irregular shift of sea temperature from the western side to the eastern side of the Indian Ocean and vice versa. That means if the western Indian Ocean becomes warmer, then the eastern part of the Indian Ocean will be cooler. Similarly, if the eastern part of the Indian Ocean is warmer, then the western part of the Indian Ocean will be cooler. This irregular shift of sea surface temperature of the Indian Ocean is called the Indian Ocean Dipole. It is similar to El Niño and La Niña in the Pacific Ocean. Now the question is, why does the Indian Ocean have a dipole? Out of the five oceans on Earth, the Indian Ocean is the warmest ocean. The second one is the Pacific Ocean. If you look at the Indian Ocean, it is surrounded by land masses on three sides. But on the eastern side, water from the Pacific flows between the islands of Indonesia and Australia and mixes with the Indian Ocean. The tropical easterlies make that happen. Tropical easterlies are winds that blow from northeast in the northern hemisphere and from southeast in the southern hemisphere. And they are located between 0 and 30 degrees north and south latitude. When the water from the Pacific Ocean moves into the Indian Ocean, it changes the surface temperature of the Indian Ocean water. Another fact is that in the northern hemisphere, the Indian Ocean is landlocked and doesn't come in contact with the Arctic waters. That means the water of the Indian Ocean is pretty much warm all throughout the year. So these are some of the reasons as to why the Indian Ocean develops a dipole. Now let's go to the next question. How does the Indian Ocean dipole work? The Indian Ocean dipole varies between three phases: neutral phase, negative phase, and positive phase. First, we'll look at the neutral IOD phase. The neutral phase begins during spring season, when temperature gradually rises. During the neutral phase, the water from the Pacific flows between the islands of Indonesia and Australia and comes in contact with the Indian Ocean. Temperatures are close to normal across the Indian Ocean. Then comes the positive IOD phase. In this phase, more and more warm water of the Pacific starts to flow between the islands of Indonesia and Australia. Now keep in mind, there are strong tropical easterly winds that flow in this region. Now these strong tropical easterly winds push the warm surface water towards the western side of the Indian Ocean, that is near Africa. When that happens, you also have to pay attention to the thermocline. As the surface water is warm, the temperature of the water below the surface is cold. When warm surface water accumulates on the western side, the deep cold water rises toward the surface on the eastern side. This process is called upwelling. Now the warm surface water on the western side of the Indian Ocean will create a low pressure zone. Always remember, low pressure will develop in the region of warm temperature. Warm temperature also creates a lot of moisture. The warm air will then rise because the hot air molecules are loose. Air expands when it is warm. After reaching a certain height, some of the warm air condenses and form clouds, which then results in rainfall. On the eastern side of the Indian Ocean, you will find the ocean water to be cooler. Cold temperature is associated with high pressure. At high pressure region, the air sinks because cool air is more dense and heavy. When cool air descends, it warms. Since it can then hold more moisture, the descending air will evaporate water on the ground. That's why the region of high pressure will usually have dry conditions. There will be no clouds and no rainfall. During this time, the southeastern countries and northwestern Australia faces severe drought conditions. On the other side, the coastline of Africa faces severe rain and floods. Air flows from high pressure to low pressure area. This is what creates the global wind belts that profoundly affect regional climate. That's how the entire circulation of air occurs. And the third phase is the negative IOD phase. In this phase, the easterly winds become weak and the westerly winds become strong. The westerly winds push the warm surface water from the western side of the Indian Ocean towards the eastern side, that is near Indonesia and Australia. When warm surface water accumulates on the eastern side, the deep cold water rises toward the surface on the western side. The warm surface water on the eastern side of the Indian Ocean will create a low pressure zone. The warm air will then rise because the hot air molecules are loose. Air expands when it is warm. After reaching a certain height, some of the warm air condenses and form clouds, which then results in rainfall. On the western side of the Indian Ocean, you will find the ocean surface water to be cooler. Cold temperature is associated with high pressure. At high pressure region, the air sinks because cool air is more dense and heavy. During this time, the southeastern countries and northwestern Australia gets rain. On the other side, the coastline of Africa faces severe drought conditions. Now, many of you might be having a question of why the easterly and the westerly winds become strong and weak. The answer to that question lies in the general circulation of the atmosphere. We know that air moves between large high and low pressure systems. That is what creates the global wind belts that profoundly affect regional climate. High and low pressure systems are created due to uneven heating of the Earth's surface, because land heats faster than water. In a nutshell, we know it is due to solar heating of the Earth's surface. We also know that Earth's axial tilt causes different seasons. So if you understand this sequence, that's the logical reason behind why the easterly and the westerly winds become strong and weak. Now coming to the question of how does the Indian Ocean Dipole affects the monsoon in India? As we have learned, during a positive IOD, the eastern part of the Indian Ocean becomes abnormally cool and the western part remains unusually warm. The reverse occurs during a negative IOD. A positive IOD is said to be beneficial for the Indian monsoon, because it pushes the rain towards India. And whenever there is a drought condition in India, a negative IOD has been found. I hope you found this video informative. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.